Big news in Washington. The Greek prime minister there today imploring President Obama to clean up Wall Street.
To Peter Barnes now with the latest on the meeting. Peter.
That's right, Liz and Liz. Prime Minister Papandreou just telling reporters again after his meeting with the president that he is not a Greek bearing a hat in hand.
No, we haven't asked for financial help. We're not asking for a bailout. We're not asking for financial help from anyone. What we are doing is, first of all, revamping our own economy. We are taking measures to put our economy on the right track.
Papandreou did bring a warning that other countries with high debt, like Greece, face the same problems Greece is dealing with right now, paying sharply higher interest rates to sell its government debt. He is putting a lot of the blame for that on speculators who trade derivatives, credit default swaps, on Greek debt. The White House says the president is giving the prime minister support in his fight against speculators by pushing for his own plans for financial regulation reform, now working their way through Congress, which includes more regulation of derivatives. And I'll leave this debate to the oracles of Fox Business, the bulls and bears. Back to you.
The one, the only. All right, thank you.
Well, Greece got greedy, and it's nobody's fault but its own, says one first-generation Greek-American businessman who's also a Wall Streeter.
Tom Balesis finds it laughable that that nation's prime minister is here telling us how to regulate Wall Street. John is the CEO of John Thomas Financial. Good to see you.
Good to see you guys. Thank you for having me on.
Well, when you see Yorgos Papandreou of Greece saying these things and telling us to clean up our debt, yes, we have our own problems, but what's he really saying here?
You know, it's frustrating on one point, and it's also very disappointing. I mean, I'm very proud to be a Greek American. I mean, my family migrated from Greece at a very young age to come here for the American dream. You know, Greece's national debt now is $413 billion and counting. You know, they are to blame for their own problems, not Wall Street, not America, no one else. Their fiscal irresponsibility got them in this position in the first place. And for him to come here and blame us and tell our president to fix this problem, I mean, it's just, you know, it's unbelievable.
How long has Greece been in violation of the European Union's debt rules?
I mean, I think now, I mean, for decades. I mean, I think now, I mean, Greece's economy has been crumbling, truth be told, for decades now, decades. And it's because of the way they run their economy. You know, to blame Wall Street and the banks and the hedge funds, I mean, the only person we have to thank for their problems in this disaster is George Papandreou.
Okay.
The socialist government. That's who to blame.
They were looking at the good times and they were spending too much, not enough revenue coming in. This is reflected through many European Union countries, frankly, here in the United States as well.
Sure, yeah.
We have our own debt issues, but looking at Greece, you, as having come from Greece, I'm dying to know, you and your family, did you used to talk, I want to say 6-8 years ago, saying, what are they thinking with their finances? Because back when Athens got the Olympics, everybody was terrified. They said, Greece can't even organize their own financial house. How are they ever going to pull this off? They did. But still, people are worried.
Yeah, Liz, you're right. I'll tell you, back when they took the money in 2001, they took the money, billions of dollars, under the table, hid it from the people. Now it's time to pay the piper, and there's chaos going on in Greece because now there's no money to pay back this debt. So everyone is frustrated, and who are they looking to blame? Well, Wall Street.
Is it that Greece, the government owns hotels, it owns insurance companies, it owns banks, which, you know, we own some of that now. But don't you think that it's sort of operating on the ethical margins for Wall Street, like firms like Goldman Sachs, to show Greece how to hide their debt off balance sheet and, you know, fake their numbers?
I mean, let's call it how it is. Back when these derivatives were flooding the market and a few of these banks put these products together, there was a lot of fees generated from putting these products together. So I guess people were blinded by the fact that there were a lot of fees associated with these deals and not focused on what would happen at the end of the road. And now we're at the end of the road and there's no money. So who's going to pay for it? You know, they don't know yet, and that's the problem.
They have to cut down their deficit. They're going to go from 12-13% of GDP down to about 9% if they can bring in the austerity plans. You know the Greek people. Will they stand for this?
You know, my father spoke to his brother today, and they're talking about selling off the islands to raise cash.
Yes, that's true.
I mean, how disappointing is that? I mean, I've been going back to Greece to visit my family. I have a big family in Greece since I've been 3 years old. Every summer I've been going back, and now they're talking about selling off the islands. You know, we would live on those islands for months at a time.
Islands. That's something.
I mean, it's so disappointing.
Yeah, I hear what you're
saying. Don't sell Delos. It's a historic island.
You better believe it.
All right. So good to see you.
Great to see you
so
guys.
Much.
Thank you very much.
Anytime. You're always welcome here.